U.S. Department of Energy and its contractor, UCOR, hosted a public event in February to highlight the transformation at ETTP and new economic opportunities for the community. The event unveiled a closure plan, providing a pathway for completion of all work at ETTP.
We have a multifaceted approach at the East Tennessee Technology Park, where we're not only cleaning the land, but we're also giving it back to the community to reuse.
The end state vision of the Heritage Center is really threefold. Right at the center of it is turning Heritage Center into a large private sector industrial park. The second end state is, again, establishing the 409th national park of our country, which is the Manhattan Project National Park. And then thirdly is the conservation, environmental protection aspect end state. And so each of these end states is not only the DOE's vision, but really the vision of the entire community.
So far, we've transferred about 800 acres at the site, another 500 acres at Horizon Center for 1,300 acres total. We expect to transfer 500 more acres this year. 100, that's for the airport. And then there will be another 150 acres transferred to the airport in about a year and a half.
The closure plan accounts for every acre on the site to provide for successful cleanup for the three integrated end states. Once home to large deteriorating facilities, EM's progress has transformed the site of the former Y-12 biology complex into an area that's ready for redevelopment. Recently, workers have completed backfilling and seeding the area where the last two buildings in the biology complex once stood. As they removed the building's foundations, crews stockpiled clean field dirt nearby for quick use and backfilling. They used clean soil from the Heritage Center site to complete backfilling in this area. These efficiencies resulted in a cost savings of $80,000 to taxpayers. When the cleanup of the entire 18-acre biology complex footprint is completed, Y-12 is planning to build a new lithium processing facility at that location. Work is also underway at Y-12 to pump tens of thousands of gallons of water from the basement of the Beta 1 building. When the facility shut down in 2011, it had varying levels of water intrusion, which resulted in large amounts of water accumulating in the basement. As workers pump that water out, it is loaded into tankers and hauled to EM's liquid and gaseous waste operations for sampling, treatment, and disposal. The two-story Beta 1 building was constructed in 1944 for uranium enrichment. Cleanup of these old deteriorating facilities will eliminate risks and enable modernization at Y-12. Workers reached the halfway mark removing concrete material at ETTP. Approximately 800 truckloads worth of material was identified for removal after major cleanup was completed at the site in 2020. So far, crews have disposed of more than 400 truckloads full of concrete debris. Removal of the remaining concrete is expected to be completed this year. Completion of this project helps continue ETTP's transformation to a multi-use industrial park and conservation area. EM is conducting upgrades in a former research reactor to keep the facility in a safe mode until it is decommissioned. The molten salt reactor experiment is still classified as an active nuclear facility with a deactivated nuclear reactor, so numerous upgrades are needed to keep critical systems safe until the facility is torn down. UCOR is making upgrades and modifications that minimize maintenance costs, reduce risks of injury and exposure, and provide reliable electric service to key systems. Crews are installing a new continuous purge system that replaces an old system and provides safe continuous off-gassing to prevent pressure building up. Workers are also installing a new roof over a portion of the facility. Stay tuned to see the progress we make next month and follow us on Facebook, LinkedIn, and Twitter.